Welcome back, everyone. This is video three for chapter six, Weathering and Soils. Besides the U.S. Department of Agriculture soil classification system, in the United States, there is a system called soil taxonomy, which includes six categories and 12 soil orders and more than 19,000 soil series. This is a very complex soil classification system. Here is a picture showing globally the different soils, soil orders. And for example, at point B, the soil would be an aridisol. Point A, in this pink area, it's an oxisol. There is a table in the book that defines each of these soil orders if you are interested in learning about that. The productivity of soils for agricultural purposes can be improved by fertilizing and irrigating. However, a lot of damage is done by careless activities. And we have to keep in mind that soils are crucial for providing food, fiber, and other basic materials. And soils are one of the most abused resources. An example of negative impact on soils due to human activity is the clearing of the tropical rainforests. Tropical rainforests are cleared for logging as well as agricultural purposes. However, the soils in these forests do not have nutrients and are unsuitable for agricultural purposes. Most of the nutrients in the tropical rainforests are found in the trees themselves. If you cut them down, there's no nutrients in the soil. Also, clearing these rainforests promotes soil erosion. An example of clearing of the Amazon rainforest, an unfortunate situation. Remember, soil is a non-renewable resource, and when we lose it because of poor practices, we are losing a vital resource. Keep in mind, soil erosion is a natural process and soil formation is very slow. The rates of erosion of soil depend on the climate, the slope, and the type of vegetation. So human activities such as deforestation and poor farming practices can enhance soil erosion. Water that is flowing on ground without trees or any type of vegetation can create sheet erosion where the soil simply gets washed away. The tiny channels that develop due to the sheet erosion are called rills, which may grow into larger structures called gullies. In this first picture here, we have sheet erosion creating these rills in an Iowa farm after heavy rains. Here, this larger rill is a gully, and this is on a Wisconsin farm. So it says just 1 millimeter of soil from a single acre can amount to 5 tons of soil removed. Every continent has unnecessary soil loss. As examples, steep slopes that are farmed on can create a situation of soil loss. However, if terraces are constructed, that can help slow the runoff and decrease soil loss. Additionally, remediation can include planting strips of grass or cover crops parallel to the slope to slow the runoff, and creating grass drainage ways rather than just having soil will prevent the formation of gullies and will help trap the soil. Let's take a look at some of these examples. Here we have crops planted in strips paralleling the contours. to decrease the runoff of rain. Here we have grass planted along drainage areas. Rather than just having soil there, which would wash away, the grass will hold it in place. And corn and hay have been planted in strips that follow the contours of the hillside, reducing soil loss because it slows the rate of water runoff. Another example of soil conservation is this waterway here that has been planted with grass to prevent the runoff of soil and prevent the formation of rills and gullies. These tree lines have been planted because this area is susceptible to erosion by wind. These tree lines provide a windbreak, preserving the soil. Well, that was a rather short video, but that concludes Chapter 6 in Weathering and Soils. Next chapter is Sedimentary Rocks.